We're replacing the static wire with an OPGW, which is a 48 count optical ground wire. It's gonna provide telecommunications from their substation to substation. It's about 88.9 miles. We're over 3/4 of the way done at the present time. We pull typically anywhere from 2 to 3.5 mile chunks at a crack, and averaging 1 to 2 poles a day.
We have a helicopter subcontractor that they are unclipping and hanging dollies. We go through, we have our tensioner, and then we pull in the new OPGW as we pull out the old. And then the helicopter crews, they come back and they remove the blocks or the dollies.
The conditions that we need to work through, as you can see, it's pretty desolate out here. It's a long ride to our show-ups, anywhere from a half hour to an hour, just to get out on the right-of-way. When it does rain out here, all the roads are dirt roads out here. They're not even gravel. It gets very treacherous with the mud. It has even shut us down for a couple of days at a crack when we do get even the slightest rain.
With it being very flat, their wind can become an issue. With a lot of it being farmland, they don't want to have damages to crops, and so that's another reason why we have the helicopter instead of using bucket trucks along the entire line.
SO system operations is already set in place, whether it be a month, 30 days, 6 weeks, whatever it be. They already have that set in place, and it is your due diligence to get that done within that time frame, because what affects this line, if we don't get this back up and running when it needs to go, it's going to affect another job, whether it's another power companies that ties in with this, and it just has a domino effect. You try to meet those deadlines to keep the reliability there for everyone.